As restaurants kick back into high gear, seafood companies say business is booming. But as Vanessa Yurkovich reports, owners are still struggling to find enough workers to keep up with that demand.
It's impossible to be in three places at once. But Nate Phillips is trying to do just that. Fishing on his family's boat, running his new clam shack, and cutting the day's catch in his fish market.
I've got two guys here besides myself. Normally I have seven.
It's the same in all three locations.
How many people's jobs do you think you're actually doing right now?
I don't even know if I could put a number on it, but for just the sake of saying, probably five.
The seafood industry, like so many others, is experiencing a labor shortage. And it's currently high season in Greenport, Long Island, where seafood is in demand.
How would you say business is going?
It's insane.
U.S. seafood prices are up 2.5% since last year, the fastest pace in years. This should be good news for Phillips, but he says customers often leave frustrated and without making a purchase. With little staff, people are forced to wait.
Are you missing out on potential business because of it?
Absolutely. I feel every day we are. Every day.
The U.S. imports up to 85% of the seafood we eat. But with slowdowns in international trade, there's even more pressure on U.S. operations to make up the loss. In Louisiana, it's the tail end of the brown shrimp season. But a lousy harvest and fewer workers means less business for places like Louisiana Newpack Shrimp Company.
We have to use temporary agencies to get people to come in, and it's hard to get them even today.
Carl Turner runs the plant and says many workers are either collecting unemployment or left the industry for good.
People want to work in different industries, cleaner industries, and it's a challenge to attract people to work in the shrimp processing plant.
In the Gulf Coast's bayous, Faith Family Shrimp Company owns this dock and five boats. But the family sold two because they couldn't find anyone to run them. It's a grueling, messy, monotonous business, but one that takes skill.
We'll start people out at a really good pay, a really good hourly pay, and in a week or two they quit. And we're like, what's going on? And it's very hard to replace them.
How often are you able to get out on the boat these days?
Myself, not that much anymore. This is the most important part to all of it. Without this, we wouldn't have anything else.